Hi everybody. Most of you already know the first part of the presentation. I hope I don't bother you with this. The ones who don't know, I hope you like. What we're going to be talking today is mainly a brief introduction on the GNU Health project, and then the new features that we are adding on 3.0. We are an NGO that works on delivering health and education with free software, and this was our first project in Santiago del Estero in 2006. And the two things that we do is one, the GNU Health, and the other one is the IWI, the International Workshop on eHealth in Emerging Economies. So GNU Health has these four layers, or these four functionality areas. The first one has to do with the people, with the community, with the socioeconomics, demographics, and so on. Second one has to do with the typical EMR, that's the doctor-patient relationship, and that has to do with appointments and evaluations and labs and so on. The third one has to deal with the health institution management itself, and that's the ERP part, finances, stock, human resources, and so on. And the final one, it's reporting, epidemiology, and trying to give information, or trying to transport that data that we have been collecting into information for the health authorities. That's where epidemiology comes up, and demographics, and so on. We all know this, so I'll just skip it. It's a free software as freedom. And the main idea with the project is, of course, trying to work with the people before they get sick. And the social medicine concept is the most important one on GNU Health. Of course, we have things that deal with a sophisticated part on the medical practice, but that's not our main goal. Our main goal is trying to give a system that works with people before patients. And this is the system of health that we really want to get in, with the primary care concept always in front. So you have domiciliary units, you have institutions and operational areas, operational sectors. You have all the demographics embedded at the party level. You have the concept of the family. And the main idea, as I said before, is empowering the person, the family, and the communities. Roberto was talking before about the Chagas and dengue fever diseases. They are part of the neglected tropical diseases, and we have put some surveys already on it. And this is one of the examples for Chagas disease. As you know, GNU Health is a set of Tryton modules, and depending on the institution that you have, you will put one or the others, or all. And we try to have a centralized patient information, so from there, it's kind of like a cockpit that it allows you to do actions or reports or any other type of things, not forgetting who you have in front. These are just some reports that you can run and get the results on the fly, in this case, in neonatology and in pediatrics. Disease groups, we were just talking before on how you can actually group conditions, so you can do automatic actions upon who you have in front, and also do better reporting with that. Some screening tools for social workers, nurses, psychologists, and any type of health professionals, and a way of exporting the information that we have into this type of wearables that, you know, they are always very handy if the person is on an unconscious level or it gets picked up by an ambulance or whatever. These are just plugins and specific modules that have to do with being able to digitally sign any type of documents that you run in your practice. In this case, we put an example of prescriptions, and we use a GNU PG privacy guard in order to achieve that. And one important aspect of this is being able to exchange information with other types of systems, and that's where HL7 comes in, and specifically we are working with the FHIR, which is the latest standard that they are using. Getting a little bit into details, we try to deal with the concept of uniqueness of data, and in this case we deal with the uniqueness of a person, not only for your institution or for your province, but for the whole world, so you can have a unique person or clinical history, demographics, and so on. And so here you have the person unique ID, and here you have a UUID that no matter where you are in the world, this is, from the mathematics point of view, practically impossible to duplicate. And you have here other type of alternative IDs, and no matter for which one you are going to be looking at, you will get that information from the patient. And sample reporting, this is an example on the population pyramid that is very, very important in demographics and in medicine. And also you can geo-referentiate any type of events that you want to, from who's living in a particular domiciliary unit, or where are the hotspots on crime or assaults or anything that you might find relevant. And this is one of the other examples that we were talking about, geo-referentiating and contextualizing the information coming from any type of violent injury. And that comes from sexual assaults, that comes from car accidents, suicide attempts, and so on. And we link it to OpenStreetMaps because OpenStreetMaps, as you know, is not only a geo-referential tool, but you can also include information on the same engine. Health campaigns, this is an example on the vaccinations. We also, or you have the possibility now to link it with the civil offices, so you can now record and get the both type of certificates, birth and death, and again contextualize what was the cause of death, what were the underlying conditions, and other type of contextual information. And again, this is another example where you can put the digital signature of the professional that you are having. So what's new on the 3.0? First of all, we have the compatibility with Tryton 3.8, and that of course deals already with the web client. These are the modules that we include now on the standard GNU Health installation. And we are focusing, again, on now having a faster and more efficient way of daily clinical practice. We also deal with network institutions, data aggregation, and, of course, synchronizing all this data coming from heterogeneous GNU Health installation. And that's thanks to B2CK synchro engine that they did for Jamaica, so now we can use it in other countries. This is something that we are working on, and now with the web client also we are thinking on whether to have the different instance or just directly use it. So in things such as making appointments and things like that, that the patient can actually just check the appointments with the health professionals and so on. We already talked about HL7Fire, and here we have an example of how we are going to be dealing with the concept of the human name. This was something that we were discussing with Cedric and Roberto and so on, because different countries and different regions use different ways of naming a person. Yet we still need to have the first name, last name, and so on, because international documents require you to have those fields. So by having this concept of human name that comes from HL7, here you have things like the current use, the text. This is how we will represent that name depending on the region, the family name, given prefix, suffix, and so on. The other thing that is coming on this version is the module for functioning and disability that complements the current ICD-10 and so on. This is not only telling you this person has this specific condition, but also how this condition affects the person in society in general. So a type 2 diabetic person can be perfectly normal in terms of how dealing with the society, or it can be crippled because his or her legs have to be amputated. So this is what this functioning and disability module does. It actually gives you a status on how can you deal a daily life in the society with specific conditions. So you have the body functions, you have the activity, and you have the participation, and how external factors, as on where you live, on which is the family functionality and so on, affects to those activities. We are also including the ophthalmology module. We are enhancing the services, such as being able now to include directly the prescription products that you have into the service document, and from there being able also to do the invoicing or billing. This is also coming on the new version. Instead of using the color-based signs, we are going to be using an icon and visual sign on the tribute. With the good thing about it is, as we were talking to the Wizard, is that I can now specify which is the specific field that has the issue. Before, it was the whole record and we had to kind of guess where was the problem. So now, in this case, we have the medicaments and what is the FDA pregnancy level. But we will do the same with, we already did with the lab results and so on. Optimize the daily practice. So now we have on the appointments things such as when you can click on the tribute and say, well, this person just got here, so check him in. And from that moment, the clocks start ticking, so you know how long the person has been waiting before being received by the health professional. Or if the person doesn't show up, then you have the no-show, and you have, you are able to actually categorize who is waiting or who didn't show up or who's actually being evaluated. Something similar we are doing with the prescription, where now you have also the possibility of getting all the default values from a specific medicament when it's linked to the product. So the presentation form, the concentration of the drug, what is going to be the administration route, and so on. All of those things are already on the medicament. So at the moment that, in this case, you have an asthmatic person and you put salbutamol, the rest of the things are going to be automatically filling for you. And of course, you always have the possibility of adjusting the values for the specific person that you have in front. But before, you actually had to go field by field putting all that information. And the other thing is, now from the prescription, you are able to include the medicament on the relevant meds that are or belong to the person itself. We have also included the a new procedures code, that's the ICD-9. It's a very nice one. Has around 4,000 procedures, and it comes to the list of the previous ICPM or ICD-10 PCS. And we are also working with a pilot of free hardware, where we are going to be using things like vital signs recording automatically taken from this Arduino card. This is going to be very handy for nurses, because first of all, you don't have to be typing, which means I can make mistakes on the writing or on the readings of the values, but also it's going to be much faster. Okay, both for this case, oximeters or electrocardiograms and so on. So these are some things that we are doing. We have improved the surgery module on things such as the surgery teams, operating rooms, reservation. On the core, we have, as I said, improved the prescription modules and the patient evaluation. We have moved the electrocardiogram out from the ICU, and now it's also part of a general practice. In hospitalization, we have also include meal order management, restaurant, and special cleaning, and so on, special needs, and bed cleaning. New models, as I said before, you know, we have already birth and death certificates, lab, and so on. New Health Update, this is something that is supposed you to run in large deployments, and it will update all your environment, not only from New Health, but also from Tryton patches. The server pass, this is already in, which allows you to kind of, in a non-interactive way, put the server password on the Tryton.com. We are moving away from Transifex, and we are using now the Poodle server at the Free Software Foundation. And we are also extending the life from 6 months to 1 year. This is because it takes, hospitals don't want to be changing every 6 months. Okay? Otherwise, by the time that you are finishing one implementation, you are going to be forced to go, and it just doesn't make sense. We are more and more now focusing in stability rather than in extra functionality. Community, these are the friends from La Universidad de Entre Ríos. We have to keep working with the universities and academias. I think that that is the best place to grow the community. And this is all from the United Nations University, and this was this year at Harvard and MIT at the United States. The work that we do with multilateral organizations like WHO, now here we have to put ICD-9 too. Looks like we were already thinking about it because we left the space in between. And as we've been talking, these are just a couple of examples on where in public health, all these examples are public health institutions. One is Jamaica, that is taking the whole country, and it's taking GNU Health in order to implement it in all their facilities. This is Laos. Our friends from B2CK have been already this year there. And this is a picture from the CMR. That's the Center for Medical Rehabilitation. This is on the Philippines, Nabota City. This is a visit to Nelson Mandela Children's Hospital that is actually now being built in South Africa. And this is the last one. I just came from Mexico. This is the state of Morelos. It's about 3 million people population. And we already took this community hospital for the implementation of any health in that region. So that's it. I hope you like the presentation, and I'm looking forward for your questions. Thank you.